Head to the west coast of America, and it's all sun, sea, sand, and celebrity, going by most media coverage. But actually, there's a hidden threat lurking behind the scenes in LA, San Francisco, and San Diego, and for everywhere else in this part of the world. This time, though, it's not earthquakes, but a situation that's come to be known as California's other big one. So this is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, is California about to be wiped off the face of the earth? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. For decades, you'll have read and heard about the big one that's projected to strike America's west coast at seemingly any moment. A monstrous earthquake, potentially unmatched in modern records, that, according to some models, could literally level entire cities. But what you might have missed in amongst all the talk of a terrible quake is the fact that, actually, there's another major and apparently imminent disaster looming on the horizon as well. The ARkStorm Scenario. The ARkStorm Scenario has nothing to do with earthquakes or fault lines, but rather, it's a coming atmospheric catastrophe that scientists claim is slowly and ominously brewing over the Pacific Ocean. It brings with it a huge sense of mystery too, however, because although our knowledge and data for hurricane seasons in the Atlantic Ocean, for the Caribbean, and southern states of America is now quite vast, the records for Pacific events are much patchier, and the patterns are, therefore, more difficult to predict. Nevertheless, scientists are increasingly confident that there's danger afoot, and they do have some past examples from history to draw upon as they try to predict what might be about to happen. According to research conducted largely by the United States Geological Survey, or USGS, major storms have struck California before. By analyzing sediment and silt levels across the region, we know that there was an event in or around the year 212, then 440, and then we have numerous further huge storms dated all the way up to the years 1750 and 1810. The most recent of all, however, occurred across the years of 1861 and 62. The gaps between storms vary. It's not as though they happen like clockwork, but researchers calculate that the storm returns on average every 150 to 200 years. 150 years from the last one, then, takes us to the year 2012. So by some measures, America is overdue. But what will actually happen when ARkStorm strikes? If predictions ring true, it'll unfold with the arrival of multiple, exceptionally strong atmospheric rivers that will bombard the California coastline. Atmospheric rivers are narrow branches of weather, carrying extreme amounts of water. In this case, they will form over the Pacific, drawing in massive amounts of moisture before lashing out across the land. These are more than just your average storm surges, though. They bring with them winds of up to 125 miles per hour, at least 6,000 square miles of major flooding, and wholly unpredictable conditions for a days-long deluge, perhaps even for a weeks-long event. In the worst-case ARkStorm scenario, we're talking more than a month of continuous, horrendous weather. It will see the highest populated state in America ruthlessly ruined by endlessly swelling waters and a potential economic cost of more than $725 billion, which is roughly three times that projected for the big one earthquake scenario. While researchers have stopped short of predicting exactly the loss of life, it's almost inevitable that many people will die during ARkStorm, either directly due to the event itself or as a result of the long-term effects during a recovery period that could take years even decades. In the aftermath of ARkStorm, power may be cut to parts or all of California for long periods of time. Agriculture will suffer immensely and may never fully recover. The delivery of supplies to all those affected would be a national and international effort, and there would likely still be many thousands of ARkStorm refugees who aren't regularly reached. Life, for all those caught up in the chaos, would become wholly unpredictable, with new problems and threats arriving daily. The winds and landslides and floodwaters of the initial event will have transformed the local landscapes, turning many of them into extremely dangerous locations, while the general physical breakdown of towns and cities would continue for long after ARkStorm itself had run its course. Indeed, that $725 billion potential bill, as estimated by the USGS, puts ARkStorm into an extremely high bracket in terms of major natural disasters that might soon happen. Add into the equation that storms of this kind are expected to strike more frequently in the future then, due to general climate change, and you'd imagine that California was all hands to the pump to prepare for what's happening, to prepare for what's coming. But actually, not really. In the past, some of the local authorities have faced criticism for seemingly not being prepared enough for the massive earthquake that's scheduled to come their way. And so, in more recent years, it would appear that more has been done to earthquake-proof certain key areas. However, critics claim that a similarly underwhelming approach might be setting in for ARkStorm at present. According to the USGS, ARkStorm could require the evacuation of 1.5 million people, maybe more. Floodwaters could reach 20 feet in depth in some parts, and around a quarter of properties in California, at least, could end up badly, perhaps irreversibly damaged. The USGS says that only perhaps 12% of California property is insured, however, so there's the very real possibility of millions more rendered homeless without any property investments instantly wiped out. What's more worrying still, then, is that the USGS warns that Californian flood protection is not designed for an ARkStorm-like event. Here's where the concerns cross over with some past and ongoing criticisms of US West Coast earthquake preparation. Multiple scientific models foretell the disasters that will one day hit, but the region is seemingly failing to match the threat with action. While the USGS does highlight that much has been done to protect the state from future flooding, it concludes that current measures are still not sufficient for ARkStorm. So, what happens next? For the residents of California, it could certainly pay to keep a close eye on weather patterns over the Pacific Ocean. And for property owners, perhaps it's time to seek out an insurance quote before it's too late. One slight ray of hope with the ARkStorm scenario is that experts say that it will, to some degree, be predictable. Unlike with earthquakes, we should be able to spot ARkStorm forming a few days before it actually reaches land. Authorities should therefore be able to organize a mass evacuation and prepare homes and buildings as best they can for what's to come. As for what will happen afterwards, it's impossible to tell. California could well be changed forever if the storm unfolds akin to the highest and most brutal predictions. Yes, after days of potentially incredible turmoil, it will then pass, as all storms do, but there really could be untold destruction left in its wake. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.